们好，我是 Skype。
你们好，我是 Eric。
我叫黄立成。
我叫蔡广燕。
我叫 Marco。
我叫 Sam。
是加聪。
我是 Damon 李浩。
啊，然后我在篮球队的时候担任首发的小前锋。
我是首发大前锋。
在篮球队的一队。
NCPA 二队的队长。
在 NCPA 打了四年校队篮球。
我现在就读于美国新泽西州立大学。
我现在 UCSC。
在加拿大多伦多大学就读。
如果没有在 NCPA 打球的话，
我就不会遇到这么多志同道合的同学们，也不会跟 NCPA 的老师现在有这么好的关系，当然也就不会回来帮助这个篮球营了。
那我觉得我就没有办法接受到一个很系统的训练。
是的，这个球队对我意义非凡。我记得来 NCPA 之前，我是一个合格的团队足球，因为我真的是很不热爱团球。觉得自己能把别人直接解决掉，但是呢，这个队伍的教练就特别的看重传球，他说传球是真的篮球中最重要的东西，没有之一，比任何人都重要。然后呢，我也开始慢慢的开始去跟队友配合，然后传球，也慢慢的融入这个团队，然后呢也得到一些成就，所以我觉得这真的是件非常，怎么说，非常有意义的经历吧，如果在这打球的话。现在社会学都发展这么迅
速，正是因为在 NCPA 打篮球，才意识到篮球不仅仅是一项自己娱乐身心的运动。在 NCPA 打篮球，这里的教练呢，会把篮球当成一种教育，一种培养你全人性的这样一种运动来教你。
而 NCPA 的篮球告诉我，双拳难敌四手，一个人打不过很多个人，你需要团队的协助和交流。才能赢得比赛。
那来到这里之后，我们的教练教会我如何利用身体的优势打篮球。慢慢慢慢的，我也不惧怕任何比我高大、比我强壮的黑人、白人。正是因为在 NCAA 打篮球，我才认识了很多能够在我无论是在学习、打球任何方面、人生指导方面，都遇到了一些比较诚挚的朋友们。
Here at NCPA, we're not worried about training professional athletes. We're actually worried about training professionals. And today, more than ever, competitive sports represents an opportunity to train professionals, really more than any other opportunity they have. And it's easy to envision that a student who's waking up at 5:45 a.m., checking on his teammates to make sure they're awake,showing up to the gym at 6 a.m. punctually, then giving every ounce of sweat they have to make their teammates better, to make themselves better, to make their school proud of them. Then showing up to class, and in class they're working hard, they got to get good grades, because if the larger school community doesn't appreciate or respect them, then the hours spent in the gym don't mean anything.Especially if nobody shows up to game day. So they know the coursework that they're doing well in is going to build the school community, which makes more people show up on game day. That's just an overall building of a program. And then after working hard in class, after school activities come, and the players show up, they help mentor the younger players. And they're mentoring those younger players to be the next generation basketball guys. And they know thatsustainably, if they make the younger guys better, then the program builds. And if the program becomes a legacy, then that's a team mentality that they can be part of and be proud of. And after the ASA activities, they're on their way home, they're picking up pieces of trash off of the field. Because they're so disciplined from practice to always leave the gym clean, they transfer those skills into other aspects of their life, because they want everything to be neat and tidy.Then they end up going home for the night, calling it a day, but they do this day in and day out. No break, every day. And just as they maybe feel like they want to give up, they push just a little more. They earn that perseverance. And on the day that they finally learn the greatest thing that any man can learn, they have a championship game,All the fans come, the whole community supports them because they've been doing all the things right. They've been taking care of the classwork, they've been working hard, everybody in the school is talking about them, everybody likes the way they they behave, the way they carry themselves. So on that day that everybody shows up to support their championship game, they learn that there is no shortcut to success. Only through hard work, dedication, perseverance, resilience, that they can be successful. There's no shortcuts. That is somebody who can be successful in any context, any setting, any environment. That's the type of people we're trying to build.